Hey guys, it's John here with Greenfish Nation. Guys, I'm excited to announce the completion of my brand new NuCanoe Unlimited kayak. So you guys stay tuned for the reveal of all the modifications and things that I've done to this kayak to make it more enjoyable for myself to fish. And maybe some suggestions that you can use as well. All right, guys, I'm going to take you from bow to stern here on my NuCanoe Unlimited. One of the very first things I've done, fishing here in East Texas, you tend to see some alligators occasionally. And I want to be able to detect those at night before they can detect me. So I've added this little Nylight spotlight here that's connected to my Yak Attack system so I can see those gators before they see me. The next thing I've done is I installed the gear pod from NuCanoe. I use this mainly for my battery storage, as you can see in here. I've got two batteries inside here. I've got Echo Worthy 30 amp lithium battery, and I've got a Lifetime 100 amp lithium battery, as well as the Yak Attack power system. Everything on this yak is powered by this power system, with the exception of my graphs here. They run on the 100 amp lithium ion battery. It is a mini version. It's just a tad bit smaller in size comparison to the 100 amp that I've got back there on my troller, but it fits perfect in this box, as you'll see here. And like I said, I've got the 30 amp that runs all of my lighting and my cameras so that you guys can see some great fishing footage. I also keep my rope in here for launching the kayak. It's a nice place to keep it, as well as my Rogue Company stand assist or drag assist strap. I keep that tucked away in there also when I'm traveling down the highway. Currently I have two Helix 9s. I have down imaging, 2D and 3D, as well as right and left side imaging. Currently have all my cables just kind of rolled up and tucked away here. Keep them behind that strap there because I'm not real sure if this is the electronics I'm going to keep on here. I'm kind of contemplating putting live scope on here, and I'll do that with two Garmin 9-inch units. I think those are the perfect size for this kayak. Moving on back, I've got the Yak Attack, the little stack packs here. I forget the name of them, but man, these dudes are handy. They will get lots of use. I have a Ram Mounts X grip here for my cell phone. I can move that anywhere up and down these tracks. I installed two cup holders from Yak Attack, one here and one in the back. Got a couple of knobs there from Ram Mount. I built myself this little tackle tray here. I can keep my pliers, my trauma shears, marker in here. In this side pocket here that fits a 3600 Plano box, I keep my fish grippers. That way when I catch a fish, I can put that dude out to kind of chill out some. I also keep an anchor here because I don't have a spot lock trolling motor, but that's I like that. That way I can anchor out. Guys, this boat has so much track. It's unbelievable. I think I measured it's got about 34 feet of track. It's unbelievable. I use foot steering on this kayak versus the hand steer that I had on my other one. I really do like that. And this NuCanoe seat, as you can see, it rotates. It'll do 360 degrees. Talking about this seat here, guys, I raised my seat up. Again, this is another homemade modification that I done. I think it was probably the best thing out there, instead of buying something 3D printed or whatever, because sometimes those things fail. I just got some 2 inch by 2 inch by 11 gauge square tubing. I drilled the holes that I needed to attach it to my rail, and I also drilled the holes I needed to attach the seat to the top of it. Man, that was money well spent. That cost me about $5 to do that, and I am really, really enjoying that. So I love that it's got the one adjust strap. You can just adjust that on the fly. Like yesterday, I was about 9 miles from the boat ramp and had a long troll back, so I decided that I'd just lay back and relax. So I laid that seat back and I just relaxed on my way back to the boat ramp. Took me about 3 hours to get back, moving at about 3 miles an hour, just because I didn't want to work my electronics, my motor too hard. Just took my time, laid back, drank a couple Gatorades right here out of my cooler that I've got here in the back. One of the new things that I've got on this kayak I'm really, really proud of is a DeWalt T-Stack box. It is very nice. It latches in place. It is on rollers, just like your kitchen drawers. It has two drawers that have adjustable trays. You can move things around. I love that. I'm going to paint all the yellow green. No, it's no longer going to be a DeWalt product. It's going to be a Greenfish Nation customization. Got the transducer thing from Yak Attack to raise and lower the transducer. I'm going to be real honest with you. I'm not real pleased with that product for $125. I feel like they could have done a lot better job on it. Maybe it's just my Helix units that don't mount up good with it. I'm not very happy with it. Matter of fact, I'm considering selling it and just putting a Scotty mount on here, I think, because it really doesn't function as well as I would like for it to for $125. You screw it in and it won't tighten up all the way. It closes up and it falls back down. But I can say this, that's the only thing about this boat that I'm not happy with. But overall, this is the best boat that I've ever been in. Guys, right here, I got a Yak Attack power system. Love that thing. Controls my inside lights, my front light, everything. It's awesome, guys. I love it. Got a little old cheap seat cushion here. Eventually, I'm hoping to upgrade and get a bottom cushion and a back cushion from Kayak Cushion. I'm working on a deal with him right now. Try to get that done. Guys, before I forget it, these Hummingbird shade covers come from MrFBombs.com. You can find him on Facebook. He makes all kinds of shade covers, kayak accessories and all. That being said, guys, I built my own dashboard and dashboard risers. I took a piece of 3x3 11 gauge square tubing and I built my risers, and I bought a piece of 4-channel, for lack of a better term, track rail from Amazon, and I created my own dashboard. I got places to mount cameras, phones, just any kind of accessory right here that you can mount with a round mount. But I love that thing. I put power in three places. I've got USB DC double power ports here in the front, here in the middle, and here in the back. All right, guys, moving to the back of the kayak. I have my catchboard right here mounted on a double header by Yak Attack. It's actually a paddle mount, but it works amazing for the catchboards. I have my PWM, and it's mounted by ram ball mount and a short arm half inch system. I put this rail blazer rod holder here because my Yak Attack flip net fits right in there. I've got another Yak Attack cup holder right here to store baits and things in, drinks, whatever. I've got a cooler here that I purchased off of Amazon for the purpose of keeping drinks and cold food and stuff in when I'm out fishing a tournament. I've got a 100-amp lithium phosphate battery here by Lifetime. It's just like the one in the front, but it's the full-size 31-class version. I trolled about 18 miles on this yesterday, and I've still got about 75%. So I'm very happy with those batteries. If you're ever hesitant about buying one of those, you shouldn't be. I've had this battery on my bass boat for 2 years before I had it on the kayak, and I've had nothing but great service out of it. I keep a lot of tackle here and rods in my black pack. This is the 13x16, and you can see here that I've got it secured down with some straps that I bought again off of Amazon, and I use these eye bolts. But I raised this box up because I didn't want to put a lot of stress, because it was really tight in the bottom corners of the kayak. So I just went down to the local hardware store and I bought a piece of 2-inch by 3/16-inch aluminum bar stock, and I cut them to the lengths that I needed them. Screwed the eyelets in, so they're double duty. They hold the bar stock down, and they also hold the crate down. To power this bad boy, guys, I have got a Newport Vessels 62-pound thrust trolling motor. This boat is extremely heavy. It's got three batteries, all of my equipment on it, and my big self at about 320 pounds, 6'7" tall. This thing's pushing me about 4.4 miles an hour. I am more than happy with that. All my steering is done with paracord. My system that I use to raise and lower my motor is on a double pulley system, so it takes very little effort to raise and lower this motor. But guys, I hope you have enjoyed the walkthrough on my NuCanoe Unlimited. As far as I'm concerned, right now, this is the best boat on the water for the money. If you guys have any questions, drop me a comment down below. If you see something that you think that I could benefit from, by all means, drop me a comment. I would really appreciate that. Until next time, guys, I'm John with Greenfish Nation, and I want to wish each and every one of you tight lines, guys.